Welcome back on my YouTube channel. In addition to my Armatan Chameleon TI Helio RC all-in-one build video, now I want to show you how to set up this quad. Stay tuned. At first, for your safety, remove the propellers. Then switch on your Tyrannus, select your model, hit the menu button, then the page button, and go down to bind on the receiver setting. Now press the bind button on your XM Plus receiver and keep it pressed. Then power your receiver. Here the receiver can be powered over the USB on my computer. If it doesn't work over the USB, plug in your battery. Then hit the enter button on your Tyrannus to select the bind option. When the green LED lights up on your XM Plus, the binding was successful. Then hit enter on your Tyrannus to stop binding. Unplug the power supply from your quad and release the bind button on the XM Plus. When you bind your quad, make sure your quad and your Tyrannus are more apart as shown in this video. To make sure your quad is bound correctly, power on your quad again and keep an eye on the LED on your receiver. If everything's fine, the green LED will light up. Now you can connect your quad with the computer to set it up on Butterflight. At first we go to the firmware flasher tab on Butterflight, there we select the Helio Spring with the latest firmware, then click on load firmware followed by flash firmware. The first thing you need to do after flashing is to go to the CLI tab on Butterflight and type EMOV update and hit enter. Then reconnect to Butterflight and if you want, you can calibrate your accelerometer. Because I'm flying in acro mode only, I will disable my accelerometer in the next steps. On the ports tab, select TBS Smart Audio on the UART 5. On the Configurator tab, I leave the mouse settings on default, so I will stay with the recommended multishot ESC motor protocol. Then I change the pit and gyro loop time to 32k, 32k, and I also disable the accelerometer as mentioned before. The settings for the receiver tab are all presetted right on default. For this quad with the XM Plus receiver, I also switch off telemetry, because the XM Plus doesn't have telemetry. On the power and battery tab, you can almost leave everything on default. Just set up your battery capacity. On the failsafe tab, I just changed AUX 12 from hold to set and set it to 1000. Because with the XM Plus receiver, I will use AUX 12 for the RSSI signal and in case of a failsafe, I want the RSSI value to drop to 0 on my OSD. Otherwise, it will hold its last position. On the pit tuning tab, I leave all on default, I just put in my rates. Then hit save and we can go on with the receiver tab. Here we can see the stick movements from the Tyrannus. I first need to choose the TAER1234 channel map depending on the channel map from my Tyrannus. Then I set AUX 12 as RSSI channel and hit save. Now we can go to the modes tab and set up the different modes to the switches on the Tyrannus. I use the SF switch on top of my Tyrannus reversed for arming my quad. On its normal position the quad is armed. If the switch is off, my quad is disarmed. I like it this way because so I just need to flip back the switch with my finger to disarm my quad in case of a crash. This switch is mapped as AUX 2 on my Tyrannus. Then I also set a switch for the buzzer and if you want to use black box logging, you can also set these modes on two switches. At last you can also set a pre-arm switch for your safety. Then you need two switches to arm your quad. Then we can skip the adjustments tab, there's nothing to do. On the motor tab, we first need to calibrate the ESCs. Therefore, we need to enable the motor testing mode and move the master control all the way up to 2000. Then plug in the battery on your quad and wait for the beeps. After that, remove the master control back all the way down to 1000 and wait again for the beeps. Now the ESC calibration is finished. At next we need to check the motor direction. For this you can run each single motor on low throttle and check the direction. On my quad, motor 2 and 3 are running the wrong direction. In order to change the motor direction, we need to connect the quad to the BL Heli suit. After connecting, you need to hit check to get the values from your ESCs. Here we also can check the ESC firmware for updates. My ESCs are all in the newest firmware out of the box, so I don't need to update them. If you update yours, I would calibrate the ESCs again. It's also recommended, and in my opinion a big improvement, to change the PWM frequency from 24 to 48 kHz. These settings affect on all ESCs. Write the settings to your ESCs and then select the single ESCs with a right click on the ESC number to change the motor direction. In my case, I need to reverse the motor direction on ESC 2 and 3. After changing the direction, I write the changes to the single ESCs. If all settings are done, disconnect from the BL Heli suit and connect back to Butterfly to run and check your motors again. Now we can unplug the battery from the quad and go to the OSD tab on the Butterfly configurator. Here I choose my preferred values I want to see in my OSD. You also can set the alarms for battery and RSSI. For RSSI I set it to 65 because I've experienced some almost failsafes after 65% of RSSI in the past. At last I set the video format to PAL, but that depends on the format of your FPV camera. I will set my Foxia Monster Mini to PAL with the help of the camera controller that comes with the Foxia Monster camera. If you're interested in my Foxia Monster setup, check the video link below, there I've linked a short video with my settings. Now all settings are done, we can unplug the quad from the computer now and make a last checkup. For this you need to power on your quad and turn on your Taranis. I also recommend to test your failsafe. Therefore, switch off your Taranis while your quad is armed. That's it. I hope you liked the video. If you have any questions, write it in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you on my next video.